Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at JR from PTC. In this example, we're going to talk about the new Select and Mask workspace in Photoshop. This workspace replaces a previous Refine Edge and Refine Mask dialog boxes in Photoshop, and it allows us to visualize and select content in a new way. But before we get started with that, I'm going to show you the layers that we're going to be working with. We have this forest here, the background, and this foreground, this bear. So we're going to mask out the bear and place them in the forest. So to access this new Select and Mask workspace, you can click on any selection tool, like the marquee tool, and then click on Select and Mask. And you'll notice that the tools bar now has only a few tools, and the properties panel on the right has some masking options for you to use. Notice the Select and Mask here under the workspace. Before we go any further, I'm going to press cancel, and I'm going to show you an easier way to access this workspace. So instead of clicking on a selection tool and then clicking on this button, just remember the keyboard shortcut Control-Alt-R. That's Command-Option-R on the Mac, and it brings you directly into this workspace without having to click on any selection tools. And the first thing we'll talk about is how you can use the tools that are found in this toolbar to make a selection. First of all, we have the Quick Selection tool, which you can get to by clicking on it or pressing the W key on the keyboard, and you can just click and drag to start making a selection. Notice that the image is currently set to the onion skinning mode. We only have a transparency of 20%. That means that the selective items are going to be shown at 100% and the deselected items are going to be shown at 20%. So we have the head partially selected, which is why it looks opaque, and the rest of the image is at 20% opacity. And if we increase that transparency to 100%, notice that the rest of the image disappears. So this slider allows you to adjust the transparency so you can make better selections. So in general, what you want to do is use the quick selection tool to select the main areas of your image, then toggle between the brush tool and lasso tool to make corrections and more refined selections to specific areas. So we have the lasso tool here and the brush tool here. We're going to talk about the refine edge tool a little later on. So let's focus first on the brush tool. This works just like the regular brush tool. If you click and drag, you'll paint essentially with white. If you think of this as a mask, this is just like painting with white. You have the same keyboard shortcuts, left bracket to decrease the size, right bracket key on the keyboard to increase the size of that brush. You can click on this down pointing arrow here and adjust the size, hardness, or spacing, or you can just simply right click anywhere on your image and that same display comes up. So we can adjust the hardness, go all the way to 100%, and you can see the hard edge there. You can also click on the lasso tool, click and drag and make a selection, and it fills in those areas. Notice that if we drag the transparency up to 100, now these are the selected areas. I usually like keeping my transparency around 20%. So now I'm going to press the W key to go back into the quick selection tool, and I'm just going to increase the brush size by tapping on the right bracket key on the keyboard, increasing the size, and continue selecting the bear. Notice that I accidentally selected the rocks where he's standing. I can either click on the minus option here, or better yet, hold Alt option on the Mac and deselect the areas that I don't like. And I can release the Alt key and continue selecting the areas that I do want to keep. At this point, I can bring the transparency all the way up to 100% just so I can see how my selection is looking. If I need a different view, I can click on this down pointing arrow and select marching ants overlay, which is actually very similar to the quick mask mode, on black. Right now, the background is not really showing black because the opacity is set to 50%, but I can increase that up to 100% or bring that down if I want to. But if I'm going to use on black, I probably would want it at 100%. On white is a similar effect, but obviously with a white background instead of black. Black and white, which is essentially the mask mode. And on layers. Right now, we're not going to see anything in the background because the background layer is disabled. So I'm going to go back into the onion skin mode, and I'm going to bring the transparency down just a little bit. Maybe not all the way to 20% this time. Maybe less now, since I've already selected the major points of my bear. And I just realized that I'm missing a spot here. So I'm going to press Z on the keyboard. I'm going to zoom in, and I'm going to press W for the quick selection tool. I'm going to tap on the left bracket key on the keyboard, hold Alt, Option, and Mac to subtract from that selection. I'm going to press Z again, then hold Alt, Option on the Mac, and zoom out. Now that I've selected the main areas of my image, I'm going to use the Edge Detection tool to remove the background and portions of the image that require additional refinement, such as the fur around the bear. So I'm going to click on the Refine Edge brush. Then I'm just going to click and drag around the edge of the bear to deselect the background around the fur. And notice that I'm going fairly quickly here. What I'm going to do now is bring the transparency back up to 100 just so we can see what we got. And I'm actually going to use the black and white because I really want to see what the mask is looking like. At this point, I can just click on the brush tool and I'm just going to paint using the plus sign there, which is essentially the white. The brush is a little hard, so I'm just going to right click and bring the hardness down and continue painting on the areas that I know that I'm going to want to keep. Then I'm going to hold Alt and just remove the areas that I know I don't want to keep. I'm going to zoom in and continue removing these areas. I'm still holding Alt to remove. I'm going to fit everything to screen just so we can see what we got. And just as a side note, if you're using the paintbrush and instead of using the add to selection, you're using subtract from selection, if you want to go back into the add to selection, you can hold shift and it adds. So if you're on the subtract to selection and you hold Alt, nothing will happen. So hold shift to add to a selection. But I usually like staying on the add to selection and then hold Alt to subtract. So now that we've refined the selection, I'm going to go into the on white view. I'm going to use some global refinements. So in some cases, you may want to smooth your selection. In this case, I don't think it's necessary, so I'm just going to leave it at zero. You can feather it, contrast, or shift the edge. I'm going to shift the edge, and I'm going to do negative values just to remove that outline that we had around the bear. And actually, now that the bear is active, I'm noticing that I'm missing a little piece here, so I'm just going to click on the brush tool and just add to the selection in this area here. You can also press X on the keyboard to disable the views, but notice what happened here. I started typing X. So in a way, I'm kind of glad that happened. I'm just gonna just get out of that and Photoshop's gonna tell me that that's an invalid numeric value, and that's true, it is. But if I just press Enter on the keyboard, I'm gonna exit out of that. And if I press X this time, I get to see the original. So I can just toggle between the original and the masked areas just to see if I'm missing a piece. I'm missing a piece here actually. So I'm just gonna paint that back in. And I'm missing another piece here. Okay, and the bear is looking pretty good. Before we press OK, I just want to mention that these controls here are very similar to what the Refine Edge and Refine Mask used to be. So we have the edge detection here with the smart radius. We have the same sliders. We have the output settings as well, and also the contaminate colors. And all these options are essentially the same as to what you had with the Refine Edge. There's also a reset button here in case you need it, and a sample all layers checkbox here in case the object you're trying to select is made up of different layers or something like that. So I'm gonna uncheck this for now, and I'm gonna press OK. Photoshop then creates a mask. If I need to go back, I can click on the layer mask and then click on Select and Mask here in the Properties panel, or you can press Ctrl-Alt-R, Command-Option-R, and you're back. All right, now that I've made this mask, I can enable the forest. I can click on the layer, press V on the keyboard, move my bear and place him accordingly right about here, and maybe scale him down a little bit. So I'm gonna click on the pivot point, drag it down to his foot. That's where I want him standing. Hold Alt-Shift, Option-Shift on the Mac, and scale in proportion by clicking and dragging on that corner handle. Position him again and press Enter. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to zoom in so you could see the edge. Notice what good of a job this feature did masking out the fur on this bear, as you can see in these areas. So it looks fairly convincing. If you notice any mistakes like I'm seeing here, you can just paint with white on the mask. You don't have to go back into the Refine and Mask workspace. So I'm just going to paint with white here to fill that part in. Now, if I wasn't explaining what all those features were and how all the tools worked, then I probably would have completed this project in half the time. I was a big fan of the Refine Edge and Refine Mask, but I actually like the Select and Mask a lot more. It's more useful. The algorithm for making selections is better. And once again, I'm going to zoom in and you can see the good job it did here on the fur around the bear. And that's pretty much it. Let me know what you think about this feature. Leave a comment below. If you enjoyed this video, then click the like button and share it with a friend. If you're new to the Photoshop training channel, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.